spent the last 2 years talking to all the political players, all the political groupings in Uganda, so that we can come together. Unfortunately, there has been a lot of interests that we have not been able to agree. That being said, I know that the people of Uganda are way ahead of us. I am convinced that the people of Uganda are already united. This week they've been telling us while I lead the People Power Movement, and it's for the sake of the election that I, together with my team, had to create the political wing of the People Power Movement, and that is the National Unity Platform. We did this because we knew that we had to answer the cries of the people to unite. We established the National Unity Platform to unite all forces of change, but it had to come as a political party. And right now, as we speak...
Sorry, I must interrupt you there, because I do want to ask you this, right? What do you have to say to Ugandans who think that you've done a great job in using your voice to amplify the voices of others, especially young people in the country? But they argue that that doesn't necessarily make you presidential material.
Well, I'm not here because I'm presidential material. There are so many people who are presidential material. They are in their thousands, but they do
not
have a voice.
Shouldn't they be the candidates?
I come here, I present myself as a glue. I present myself as a glue to put together all this resource. What we need right now is a leadership that will lead us through this dictatorship. Right now, as we speak, I know that I'm fully qualified to lead Uganda. But again, I know that it's not my qualifications alone. It's the qualifications of all the Ugandans that want change. This is, I'm not doing it as a person, we are doing this as a team. But again, I must also say that I am presidential material, I'm well educated, I'm well researched and well traveled. But most importantly, if we are to compare with a president that has presided over our country for more than 34 years, he is not as educated as I am. He was not as credible as I am. And he was around my age when he came to power, when he took over the country.
Fair enough.
I want to believe that I am as qualified as him or even more.
Fair enough. And I want to bring this conversation to you, Mr. Kyagulanyi, because what is it that you are offering Ugandans? Talk to us about some of your policy. Let's talk about next year's election. Assuming you get the job and you are president of Uganda, what is the first thing, for example, that you'll do as the president?
I, together with my team, want to put an end to a lawless leadership. We have five core principles that we are targeting. One is the rule of law and respect for human rights, which you don't have in Uganda. The laws exist. We have the most beautiful constitution, and we have amazing laws which we do not respect, which the government in Uganda does not respect. So we want to return the rule of law and the respect for human rights. As a common person, one of our biggest cries has been the health sector, because we lose so many people that we shouldn't be losing. More than 300 children a day and more than 19 women giving birth die in Uganda on a daily basis. We want to improve the health sector, we want to improve education, we want to improve agriculture, because that is the bedrock of our economy. We want to bring back the ownership of the natural resources and land of our country to the hands of the people. And most importantly, finally, we want to unite our deeply divided country, divided along ethnic, class, and religious and political lines. We want to unite our country and then project a better image of our country, because we as Ugandans, we are better than the way we are being represented, or rather misrepresented.
All right, that is Robert Kyagulanyi, better known as Bobi Wine, talking to us from Kampala, Uganda. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
So we could give you hundreds of clips like that from governors, including Democratic, or Democrat as I call them, governors, which is actually the correct term. We could give you hundreds of clips just like that. We have them. We didn't want this to go on too long, but I just want to say,